Hello everyone, welcome to Talent Metal. In this video, we will discuss about pseudocode round in Capgemini's recruitment test. So first of all, what is pseudocode? Pseudocode is an informal way of programming description that does not require any strict programming language syntax. Main aim of the pseudocode is to improve its readability without any programming language barrier. Some statements in pseudocode are written in plain English, whereas some statements in pseudocode can also be written in any programming language. To solve the questions based on pseudocode which are asked in any placement test, we need to have basic general coding knowledge such as functions, recursion, conditional statements, loops, etc. Let's directly solve some questions based on pseudocode which will improve our understanding in this regard. Here is the first question. What will be the output of the following pseudocode? Pseudocode given is integer ABC. First of all, we are setting a value of B as 10. After that, for each A from 1 to 4, we are doing B is equal to B plus A. After exiting from this for loop, we are doing C is equal to B divided by 5. And at the end, we are just printing the value of C. So whatever will be this output of this print statement, that value we have to find out. Alright, so this for loop is going to execute for 4 times for a value of A as 1, 2, 3 and 4. Alright, and in this for loop we have statement B is equal to B plus A and value of B is initialized as 10. Alright, so in our first iteration when value of A will be 1, we will have the statement as B's value will be 10 and A's value will be 1, so value of B will become 11 in this particular case. Alright, so in the second iteration when value of A will be 2, in this case value of B will be 11, value of A will be 2, so overall value of B will now change as 13. In our third iteration when value of A is 3, we will have our statement as B is equal to 13 plus 3, that value is 16, so value of B will be updated as 16. And in our last iteration we will have B is equal to 16 plus 4, in this case value of A is 4, so 16 plus 4 is 20, so value of B will be updated as 20 now. So after this fourth iteration, that is after value of A is 4, we are going to exit from this particular loop. And after exiting from this loop, we have this statement C is equal to B divided by 5. So now we have value of B as 20 and 20 divided by 5, that is nothing but 4. So value of C will be 4 and we are just printing that value here. So the answer for this question will be this B option, that is 4. Next question. What will be the output of following pseudocode for input A is equal to 2 and B is equal to 4? In this pseudocode, this fun function is given in which the parameters are integer A and integer B. Now within this function, this variable integer N is initialized to 0. After that, in this if condition, if B is less than 1, then we are returning N. In the else part, we are returning function of a plus b plus 2, comma b minus 2. Alright, so this recursive function call is made in this pseudocode. And whenever these kind of recursive function calls are made, it is always a good idea to draw the function frames and then manually solve the example. So in this case, we will draw function frame for the very first function. Alright, in this value of a is 2 and value of b is 4. Now in this first function, this b is less than 1 condition is not satisfied because value of b is 4. So we will not enter in this if part. So we have to execute this else part here. So else part is this return statement, that is return function of a plus b plus 2 and b minus 2. Okay, so if we substitute these values, a plus b plus 2 will become 2 plus 4 plus 2, that is nothing but 8, and b minus 2 value will be 2. So this next function call will be made. Now we will draw the function frame for this next function. In this function frame, value of a will be 8, value of b will be 2. After that, again this if condition is not satisfied, a value of b is not less than 1. So we have to execute the condition in else part, that is return fun of a plus b plus 2. This a plus b plus 2 value in this case is 12, and b minus 2 value in this case is 0. Alright, so this function call is made again. Now in next function, value of a is 12 and value of b is 0. So notice here that in this particular function, this if condition b is less than 1 is satisfied as value of b is 0. So that is why we will return n from this particular function. So we are going to return value of n. N value is 0. So we are returning 0 from this function to the earlier function. Alright, so the value of this fun 12,0 in earlier function will now become 0. So we are in a way returning 0 from this particular function. So if we return 0 from this function to earlier function now, then here also this whole statement of fun of 8,2 will become 0. Alright, so this in turns return 0. And that is why the output for this particular pseudocode will be 0 itself. So this A option is the right answer. Next pseudocode. In this pseudocode, this character array text is given, which is initialized to string test string. After that, two integer variables A and C are declared. Then one character variable CH is initialized to value T. Then our integer variable C is initialized to 0. Then this is important part, we are running one loop. In this loop, for each A from 0 to length of text, we are checking if text of A is equal to CH. Remember that value of this CH variable is T. So if text of A is equal to CH, we are incrementing the value of C. So that is why C is equal to C plus 1. This is all we are doing in this for loop. After exiting from this for loop, at the end we are checking if value of C is greater than 0. If it is, we are printing that value of C. Otherwise, we are printing 0. So in essence, all we are doing in this pseudocode is we are incrementing the value of C for each occurrence of T in the test string. Alright, because text of A has to be equal to CH, that is has to be equal to T if we have to increment the value of C. Now we know the letter T has occurred 3 number of times in this text character array. So that is why the value for C after the end of this for loop will be 3. And we are going to just print that value of C here, that is option B. Next question, what will be the output of following pseudocode? We are given 4 integers a, b, c, d. So I will just write these variables here, a, b, c, d. Value of a is initialized as 14, value of b is initialized as 15, and value of c is initialized as 16, and d is not initialized yet. Now we are checking if a is greater than 6. Now we know a value is 14. So 14 is definitely greater than 6. So we are entering into this condition. We are doing b is equal to c minus a. Now value of c is 16 and value of a is 14. So we are doing 16 minus 14 here. So value of b will be updated as 2. After that, if a is greater than c. Now we know value of a is 14, value of c is 16. So if 14 is greater than 16, we know this is not true. So we are not going to enter in this if condition. So we have to perform this else part now. In this else part, we are doing d is equal to b minus c. So value of b is 2, value of c is 16. So 2 minus 16, that is nothing but minus 14. and we are assigning this minus 14 value to d. So value of d will be minus 14, and at the end we are just printing this value of d. Remember that we are not going to perform this else condition part because we have already entered in this if condition. Okay, so all we have to do is just print the value of d now, and value of d in this case is minus 14. So we will be printing minus 14 here. So this A option is the right answer. Next question, what will be the value of t in the following pseudocode if A is 56 and B is 876? This is our pseudocode. First statement in pseudocode is read AB. This is nothing but take input for A and B. Now this input is already given, that is A is 56 and B is 876. Below that we have this function MUL with parameters A and B. In this function we have this variable t initialized to 0. So till now we have three variables. First variable is t, second variable is a, and third variable is b. Now in this case, in this function we are running this while loop. While b is not equal to 0, we are doing t is equal to t plus a, and we are updating the value of b as b minus 1. Alright, so in our first iteration, value of t is 0, value of a is 56, and value of b is 876. Now in this iteration of while loop, we are doing t is equal to t plus a. Alright, so t plus a in this first iteration will be 0 plus 56. So value of t will be updated as 56 now. And after that we are doing this b is equal to b minus 1. Okay, so value of b will be updated as 875 now. Okay, so in this case this b is our iterator for the while loop. Alright, so until and unless this value of b is not equal to 0, we are going to iterate this loop. Now obviously it is not possible for us to manually write down such 876 steps until the value of b goes to 0. So we will have to find some pattern in the changing values of t, a and b. Alright, so in the second iteration we will have value of t as 56, value of a is not changed, so it will be 56 as it is, and value of b will be 875 now. Now in this second iteration of while loop, we are again doing t is equal to t plus a. So in this case it will be 56 plus 56. So value of t will be 112 now, and value of b will now become 874. In our third iteration now, value of t is 112, value of a is 56, and value of b is now 874. Now in this third iteration, again this particular statement t is equal to t plus a, this will be 112 plus 56, that is nothing but 168. So value of t will be updated as 168, and value of b will be decremented by 1, so it will become 873. Okay, so if you look at this values of t's, you will notice some pattern. This is nothing but the multiples of 56. So first value was 56, then 112, then 56 into 3 was 168, and of course this pattern will go on until this value of b will become 0. Okay, so all you have to find out now, how many times this while loop is going to iterate. So if value of b was initialized to 876 and we are iterating till the value of b is greater than 0, it means we are going to iterate this loop for 876 times itself. So at the end of this while loop, the value of t will be 56 into 876. And if you do this calculation, the value of t will be 49056. Okay, so this B option is our right answer. So a very important tip from this question is, when the input values given are large, that is in this case value of B was given as 876 And whenever we have to make too many iterations of a loop, for example, in this case, we had to make 876 iterations, or if in some case we had to make too many function calls. So in that case, it is obvious that you have to find some kind of pattern in the changing values of the variables. Okay, so likewise, in this case, we found out that the value of t is nothing but a multiple of 56. Okay, so and for finding out the answer, we just multiplied this 56 by 876 and we found out the answer. It is not at all practically possible to write down 876 such steps manually and then come to the answer. We do not have so much time in our hand in the test. Okay, so whenever these kind of questions come in exam, please keep this particular thing in mind to find the pattern of the changing values of variables. Next pseudocode, what will be the output of following pseudocode is the question. This pseudocode is pretty straightforward. There are no loops as well as there are no function calls made. So first of all, we have taken two variables m and n. M is initialized to 9 and n is initialized to 6. Then we are doing m is equal to m plus 1. So value of m will be updated to 10. After that, next statement is n is equal to n minus 1. So value of n will be updated to 5 now. Then we are doing m is equal to m plus n. So value of m will now change to 10 plus 5. That is nothing but 15. After that, we are checking if value of m is greater than n. So m in this case is 15 and n we have right now is 5. So indeed this if condition is true, so we are going to print this value of m now. Now value of m is 15, so we are going to print 15. Alright, and anyways we are not gonna enter into this else condition as we have already executed this if part. So this D option is our right answer. So this was a very simple question. Next question, what will be the output of following pseudocode for n is equal to 2? We are given this pseudocode in which there is this function fun which has a parameter as integer n, and we are making the recursive function calls to this function fun in this pseudocode. So obviously we have to draw these function frames now. Whenever such kind of recursive function calls are made, it is always good to draw these kind of function frames. Okay, so for first function frame, we have value of n as 2. Now in this case, we are checking this condition. If n is equal to 4, we are returning value as n. Now obviously, this condition is not true in the first case. So we are going to go in this else part. Okay, so in this else part, we are returning value as 2 into 4. Next function call is made. So this for this function call, value of parameter is n plus 1. So n plus 1 value will become 3 in this case, and we are calling this next function now. Okay, so for this next function, value of n is 3. Again, this if condition is not satisfied in this case, value of n is not equal to 4. So we are going to enter in this else part. In this else part, we are returning value as 2 multiplied by function of n plus 1. Now, n plus 1 value will be 4 in this case. So we are going to call this function again. Okay, so for next function, value of n is 4. Now in this case, this if condition will get satisfied. Value of n is indeed equal to 4. So we are going to return the value of n, which is 4. So we are gonna return 4 to the function call made here. So this particular statement in our earlier function will now become 2 multiplied by 4, which is nothing but 8. And we are going to return this 8 value to the earlier function call made, which is this. Okay, so this statement 2 multiplied by function of 3 will be replaced as 2 multiplied by 8, which is nothing but 16. And we are returning this 16 value to our answer. Okay, so this option A is our right answer. Next question. What will be the output of following pseudocode for input 4? Now in this pseudocode, again, one function is given. Function name is sum and it is taking parameter as int num. Now in this case, this if condition, we are checking num is not equal to 0. And if this condition is true, we are going to execute this statement, that is return num plus num multiplied by sum of num minus 1. Okay, so this recursive function call is made here. So by now we know that whenever these recursive function calls are made, it is a good idea to draw function frame. So in this first function frame, value of num is 4. Okay, because we have our input as 4. So value of num is 4. Now this particular condition, that is num is not equal to 0, will hold true here because 4 is not equal to 0. So we have to execute this statement, that is return num plus num multiplied by sum of num minus 1. Okay, so value of num in this case is 4. So 4 plus 4 multiplied by next function call, that is sum of num minus 1 is 3. Okay, so this function will get called again. Now in this case, value of num will be 3. So we are drawing this next function frame with num value as 3. Now in this case, again, this if condition will hold true, that is num is not equal to 0. So we will again have to execute this statement, that is return num plus num multiplied by sum of num minus 1. Now value of num is 3 in this case, so it will be 3 plus 3 multiplied by sum of 2. Alright, and in this way we are going to make this next function call for this sum of 2 value. Now as you can see here, this is following some kind of pattern, this return statement. That is, first return statement was 4 plus 4 multiplied by sum of 3. Then for next function frame, it was 3 plus 3 multiplied by sum of 2. So as you can guess, for next function frame, when value of num will be 2, it will be 2 plus 2 multiplied by sum of 1. And after that, for next function frame, it will be 1 plus 1 multiplied by sum of 0. And for next function frame, when value of num will be 0, because we are calling this sum function now with the parameter passed as 0. So whenever this value of num will be 0, we are going to execute this else part of the condition, that is return value of num. So from this next particular function, after this function call, this return num statement would be executed in next function frame, where num value would be 0. So this 0 will get returned to earlier function call. So this earlier function call will now become 1 plus 1 multiplied by 0. Okay, so 1 plus 1 multiplied by 0, that this value is nothing but 1. So to earlier function call, value 1 will get returned. So now in this particular statement, that is 2 plus 2 multiplied by sum of 1, this statement will change as 2 plus 2 multiplied by 1. So this value is 4. So 4 value would be returned to the earlier function call. Okay, so earlier function call, which was 3 plus 3 multiplied by sum of 2, will now get changed as 3 plus 3 multiplied by 4. So this value is nothing but 3 plus 12, and it is 15. So 15 would get returned to earlier function call, which is this function call. We are returning value 15. So this very first function will have to execute this statement now, that is 4 plus 4 multiplied by 15. and this value is 4 plus 16. This is nothing but 64. Alright, so this first function will return 64. So this C option is our right answer. Next question. What will be the output of following pseudocode? Now in this case, in this pseudocode, we have given these three integer variables n, beg and end. Now this beg value is initialized to 5, end value is initialized to 7 and sum value is initialized to 0. Now in this case, we are first of all checking if this beginning is greater than end. Now beginning value is 5 and it is not greater than 7, so we are not going to execute this statement, so we will go into this else part now. Okay, so in this else part we have this for loop. In this for loop we are iterating through when n is equal to end till n is greater than or equal to beginning, and we are decrementing the value of n. And after exiting the for loop, notice here that we have to print the value of n. So this particular statement in our for loop, that is sum is equal to sum plus n, this holds no significance as far as our output is concerned, because we are nowhere using this updated value of sum. So even if we don't focus on the value of sum, it is okay. All we have to focus is on the value of n. All right. So for the first iteration of this for loop, value of n will be initialized to end. End value is 7 in this case. So value of n will be 7. After that, we are doing this sum is equal to sum plus n. We can ignore this particular statement. And we are doing n is equal to n minus 1 in our loop. So value of n will be updated to 6 now. After that, for next iteration, before doing next iteration, we are doing this n is equal to n minus 1 in the loop condition also. Okay, so value of n will be decremented again. So for next iteration, value of n will be 5. Now as you can see, this condition, that is n is greater than or equal to beg, holds true now, because beginning value is also 5 and n value is also 5. So we are going to iterate this loop for the next time. Again, this sum is equal to sum plus n statement can be ignored. And now we are doing this n is equal to n minus 1 statement. So value of n will now become 4. Now after that, we are again going to do this n is equal to n minus 1. Okay, so value of n will become 3 for the next iteration. Now as this condition, that is n is greater than or equal to beg, will not hold 2 now, because value of n is 3 and value of b is beginning is 5, so this not holds true. So that is why we have to exit from the loop in this case, and after exiting we are just printing the value of n, and as we know value of n is 3, so this D option is our right answer. Now the important tip from this question was, whenever this kind of pseudocode is given, first of all read the whole pseudocode. Alright, in this case we found out that at the end we just have to print the value of n. So this particular statement where we were updating the value of some variable, we decided that this statement is not at all important for us and we just focused on this variable n. So solving of this question became significantly easy. Alright, so that previous question was the last pseudocode we were gonna see in this video. Before concluding this video, just a final piece of advice. Whenever solving this kind of pseudocode based questions, it is always a good idea to do some paperwork. Don't try to solve these questions orally. By doing this paperwork, these pseudocode based problems become very easy and our chances of making mistake reduce significantly. Alright, so thanks for watching this video and please subscribe to our Talent Battle YouTube channel to get latest placement updates.